Rachita's gonna hate me while he edits this because I repeat everything so many times. It's getting very hot over here. These questions are also very hot. I won't say it's nothing so great also. Okay, before you ask, this makeup look is gonna be up on my YouTube shorts, so you can stay tuned for that. And also, this look is very much inspired by this dress I'm wearing, which is by Skion Apparel. I feel very cute in this outfit, and I know it's not matching the title or the context of the video at all, but hi you guys, welcome back to another video, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I am doing something that has been trending on YouTube currently, and that is Girl Talk, the TMI tag. I saw Mridul do this, I also saw Simi do this, so I thought I would hop on board and answer a lot of questions that y'all have about girl hygiene, feminine issues, and a lot of stuff that's hush-hushed in the society and we don't talk about very often, especially like with our families or with, you know, this is the sex ed you should be getting at school, but you're not getting it. So here we are giving you the much necessary sex ed, but making it fun as well. I'm not just your girlfriend Sara Sarosh anymore. I'm also an occupational therapist. I'm Dr. Sara Sarosh now. I come with a place of knowledge as well as expertise. Of course, my knowledge is not specific to gynec, so don't take it that way. But I do come from a place of knowing what I'm talking about. And with that in mind, let's dive straight into today's video. But before that, if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi guys, I'm Sara. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. If this is the first time you've come here, take a moment and hit the subscribe button, join the Sara squad. I'm sure you'll have a great time here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, let's dive straight into this. Not taking names, keeping it completely anonymous, the first question I have is, have you ever seen or tried for yourself waxing down there? Now, personally, I have never tried a bikini wax ever, and this makes me feel like I should try it because I have seen a lot of people talk about how bikini wax just makes it so much easier. It makes it smooth and soft, and like the hair doesn't come for a really long time, which is amazing because I don't like to have any hair growth down there. It's just a personal preference. But also in general, to get a waxing done, you need to like grow the forest completely to then make it a deserted island. So I don't even want to reach the stage that my forest is completely bloomed, if you know what I mean. So I've not tried at all, but I've heard great things about it. If you have a good pain threshold, I definitely think you can go for it. How do you tackle with people who judge you on the basis of clothes? Much needed response on this. Now, this is something I still till today face, even in my own home. Like sometimes, you know, I'm wearing shorts and my dad doesn't allow it, and sometimes I can't go out in shorts and everything. Like this is something that I always have battled in my own home as well. So that kind of confidence that you're trying to build on yourself just goes away when you are not allowed to wear what you want to wear. When it's outside people, I don't care. But when it's my home fam telling me something about the way I dress or about the clothes I wear, of course it hits harder. I've just hit a point where I'm like, you know, trying to make them understand that this is how I dress, this is how I'm comfortable in my body, and how you look at it is a problem and not how I dress in it. It's definitely a journey of learning for them. It's not gonna happen overnight, but I'm still working on it and I take it slow with that. But I continue to do what I want to do. Within how many hours should we change our sanitary pads? So this depends on your flow. If your flow is really heavy, like on your first, second and third day, you should definitely try to change your pad every 4 hours. Don't try to keep it on for very long because then it'll start to stink. So that stench also stays on for very long. If you don't have access to a washroom, what I used to do in school and college, instead of wearing one long pad, I used to put double pad. So it just had more absorbing capacity. But now I've switched to tampons. Tampons I switch every 3 hours on a heavy flow day. And now I switched to menstrual cups, so that's sorted. You can keep it on for like 6-7 hours, no leakage, no stinking, nothing. Super short life. If you're not on a heavy flow day, like on your third, fourth day, you can keep it on for 7 hours at the maximum, but 7 hours later you should ideally change your pad. Do you believe in those period rituals like kitchen and especially temple or church one? I am forced to. Now the period ritual is basically that in some religions or some cultures do not allow you to enter the kitchen, enter the temple or a place of worship. I don't believe in per se, but also I cannot do or go against. You know, when it comes to culture and when it comes to religion, there are such hard lines that you sometimes just cannot surpass. Churches you can go when you're on your period, so that is not like that. Religion part of mine does not believe in that. But in Muslims, they do believe that you're napak when you're on your period. Now that term napak is something that has always bothered me since a child, because you know your periods are already a very hard time for you when you get your puberty and when you get your first period. to know that you're na pak is just not okay, because hello, I got my period, it's a thing that's naturally supposed to happen, it's God given, and you're telling me I'm not pak, that means I'm not holy just because I got my period, it's not okay. I know for a fact that tomorrow when I have a child and if she wants to follow Islam, I will not tell her she's napak. I might tell her that, okay, you don't pray namaz because it's, you know, against the rules or whatever. That's why I don't pray namaz. You can just keep talking to God and he's always with you. But that's just a way you talk to girl child and not stigmatize them. Okay, you can't go to the kitchen and temple and everything. Now, when it comes to kitchen, in my household, we do go to the kitchen all the time. Apart from the one time my mom doesn't allow us to go to the kitchen when we are chumming, is when masalas bhar rahe hote na, like pure saal ka ration ka masala they make and they mix it. How to tone up sagging breasts? It's really heavy. I even wear a bra for 24 hours, fir bhi kuch nahi hota. Listen, girl, you don't have to wear your bra for 24 hours. It's not gonna help you. Now, a certain cup size and above will cause a sagging breast because it's very heavy on your body. Number one thing that you can do to help yourself is correct your posture. Just sit up straight, you know, correctively remind yourself that you have to sit up straight. It does really help the posture and uplift your bust area. Apart from that, if the breast itself is sagging, you can't do much. Exercise really helps, like do push-ups, because that really helps tone your pectoral muscles. That's your chest muscles. Once they get toned up, your breast will get a little more uplifted. Wearing a bra for 24 hours is not really doing you good. Of course, in the day you can wear it because you'll just need that added support all throughout the day. But at night time, please, I advise you remove your bras and go to sleep. Sleep comfortably. You're in an anti-gravity position. It's not really gonna help anyway. And even if you have sagging breasts, it's completely okay. It's normal, you guys. It's gravity. It's pulling it down. So what can you even do? You know, just enjoy your boobs. I mean, just have fun, dude. Just forget about those sagging breasts. Who even cares? Bleeding after the first time having sex, does it happen second or third time as well? Now, there's a very small, rare possibility, like a 5%, 2 to 5% chance that you might bleed on your second time having sex as well. And that would only be if you've not gone the complete mile the first time. You know, there are some people who don't completely have sex the first time itself, but you know, your hymen might still break and you might bleed the first time. So if it's not completely torn, the tissue is not completely torn, the hymen, then there might be some amount of bleeding the second time as well. But it won't happen the third time for sure. Don't be scared. I was molested and raped. Even after knowing this, my boyfriend used me. How to recover? Now, this is a very sensitive subject, but I know it's very common. Molestation and rape is something every girl child period, I won't even say girl child in India, is familiar with, and that just sucks. It's a trauma you have to heal from. Your boyfriend using you, I don't know in what context you're saying. I don't know, it means that he's also trying to impose himself on you. If that is the case, you still have the upper hand here. He's your boyfriend. Either you can talk this through with him or you can leave him. Make the wiser choice for yourself and your own sanity. You know what kind of a level of trauma you have. So this is not something you can just recover and I can just tell you that do this and you'll be okay. You have to heal from within, accept that this has happened and let go of it completely. It took me a very long time to get over it. It was not even rape. I'm alhamdulillah blessed that I have never been raped before, but I was definitely molested and it's happened to me multiple times. Talk to your girlfriends about this. This is a matter that your girlfriends would understand and support you and, you know, talk you through. And also, if you think your mom would understand this subject, then you should share this with her as well, because at the end of the day, it is something, it's your matter of security. So you should let as many people as possible know. Like, I'm talking about this widely on the internet because it is a harsh reality. We should all talk about it. If a teenage girl will use a menstrual cup for the first time, then will her vaginal lip, the outer part, will it get sore? So now your vaginal lip might get sore, that is your labia might get sore. It gets sore for me as well. You don't necessarily have to be a teenage or a virgin or a first timer for that. For me, this period cycle, I'm currently wearing my menstrual cup. This is the second time I'm trying my menstrual cup out. I've been so comfortable with it that I don't even want to wear my tampon or pad at all. Like, pad is out of question, but tampon also at all. Of course, when I'm repetitively putting it, like every 3-4 hours, if I'm changing my menstrual cup or want to empty it, then thoda sa soreness hota hai, but it's nothing like I can't sit or, you know, it's very bad or anything like that. Like the period rashes I used to get because of my pads, it's not like it at all. maybe the first time you wear it and you are not used to it, you might feel very tight and constricted. So just relax and do it. Have your own experience. It will go away with time. Is a little brown discharge normal before your periods? Absolutely normal. It could just be the last endometrial lining, the last period cycle ka blood, which is like excreting itself from your body. Or it could just be the initial start of your new period. So it's completely normal. Discharge before your period, it's a part of PMS. Is it normal to get hair growth on your stomach, chest and back just after hitting puberty? Absolutely, hair growth everywhere after puberty is very, very normal. You experience all sorts of hair growth, your facial hair, your underarm hair, your pubic hair, everything changes texture and also increases in growth. So you will experience all of that. It's a rough time, puberty, but that's why it's, you know, puberty hits hard. When it after that phases away, it'll be your glow up phase. Is uneven breast normal and what's the reason? Uneven, everything in your body is normal. Your body was not made to scale, you know, it's not supposed to be equal on both sides or symmetrical on both sides. You will observe one eyebrow is like a little less arched than the other, or your one eye is a little smaller than the other. All of these things, it's just natural. It's normal. It's how your body's supposed to be. So boobs are also not symmetrical on both sides. They are a little asymmetrical. It's completely normal. Sometimes zyada bhi hota hai. So if you feel it's too drastically different, then you can consider getting implants later on if you want to, not because your partner wants or somebody else wants you to get it. What's the best hair removal trick? Veet, Venus razor or waxing, and which one lasts long? So the longest lasting hair removal has to be laser, because that's like hair reduction. So agar in mein se tumhare option laser bhi hai, to of course that would be the ultimate. Waxing definitely lasts longer, but to get a good wax, you have to have a good hair growth. So that is the one reason I do not like waxing. Also, the fact that it hurts for no reason. And Venus razor is my preferred method because I just keep it in my washroom every like a week. I can shave my legs, I can shave my hands, I can shave everywhere very fast. It's fast, it's quick, and it's efficient. And whenever I want to go out, if I feel like I have a little bit of peachy fuzz, I can just shave it off. So that's my preferred method. Veet, on the other hand, I used to do when I was very young, like when I just started like hair removal. That is when I tried Veet for the first time, but I observed some amount of hyperpigmentation because of that cream in my underarms is where I was using it. So I stopped using Veet completely. Does the first sex have to be really painful because I have a date on 4th of July? Okay, so it's not necessary. To be very honest, first sex for me was not painful at all. It was a breeze. I did not even, like, I can't say I didn't feel a thing. I definitely felt something, but it was not painful. Look, don't be scared. If you have a date, all the very best. Be mentally prepared for it. It might hurt a little bit because I know from my girlfriends that it does hurt the first time for some people. But then again, for some people, it does not hurt at all. This also has to do with the fact that if your hymen is intact or no before, like if it's broken previously due to some sports injury or something, like I previously mentioned, then you won't bleed on your first time and then it will be much easier for you. What's very important, I think, for your first time having sex is the partner you're doing it with. You have to be very comfortable with the person whom you're like losing your virginity to. So if that other person is just helping you be comfortable and confident, you'll have a breeze of a time and you'll have fun. So just go with a fun mindset, and I hope you're doing it with somebody you trust. I'm 17. It's been 2 years since I'm getting my periods, but then too, I didn't get my periods on the exact date. Now, there are a lot of reasons for your periods being late. One major thing has to do with stress. Second thing also has to do with PCOS. Now, stress is a precursor for PCOS. A lot of stress leads to your hormones basically being out of whack all the time. When it happens for a prolonged period of time, that is when you develop PCOS completely, the entire spectrum of syndrome of symptoms that you experience, like male pattern balding, you have hair loss, you have weight gain, you have cystic acne. I am somebody who has PCOS, so I'm speaking with experience on that forefront. It is normal for your periods to be delayed. What you can do is lifestyle modifications. Can't tell you take less stress because that's not in your hand, but you can try relaxation techniques, try meditation if that helps you, try yoga. exercise regularly, exercise genuinely helps so much to regulate your periods. I can't even tell you. All of my PCOS ka gyan I have left in this playlist right here, so you can check it out. My PCOS journey, my diet, my workout, everything is mentioned there, so you'll have great help if you check that out. Please tell us your experience on contraceptive pills. Did you have any side effects? Now, if you know me from a while, I have mentioned in my PCOS playlist only that I took contraceptives for 4 years. Now, that was not because I was actually aiming for contraception. Contraceptive pills are a way to cure PCOS, or basically to manage PCOS. What they help you to do is balance your hormones. I had a severe bout of cystic acne. I used to get terrible cystic acne. Taking those pills would immediately cure my cystic acne, like absolutely gone. I took it for 4 years. After that, I phased it out slowly and steadily and then made lifestyle modifications with my diet, consumed less dairy than before, and adding workouts and everything has helped me over the course of time. But my periods were a breeze when I was taking contraceptive pills because they were so regular. I would never miss a period. I would not feel any PMS symptoms. In fact, today, now that I've stopped contraceptives, my PMS is bad. During PMS, ek jhagda to mera kisi na kisi ke sath hota hi hai. I don't know if there are long-term side effects that I might face later on during fertility or anything. What I know for a fact is that 4 years was not a good amount of time. Maximum you should take on a continuum for 2 years contraceptive pills. Usse zyada you should not, ideally. But nobody was there to guide me correctly at that time, and I did not have so much knowledge tabhi. One of the side effects that you can face is DVT, that is deep vein thrombosis, that is basically clotting. So if you have a clotting disorder or a tendency to clot from before, you should avoid contraceptives in general. And when you're on contraceptives, you should definitely exercise and not lead a stagnant life. Okay, the next question is, does sex always have to be painful? The answer is not. No, absolutely not. Like, why would you keep on doing something that hurts you, right? So it's not a toxic relationship. Sex is not always supposed to hurt. It's supposed to be pleasurable. That pain is supposed to also feel good because you're under the phase of hormones. If you're always feeling only pain during sex, there could be multiple reasons for that. Number one could be you're not turned on enough, you're not interested in having sex at that time or with that person, and if that is the case, you should just stop or ask the person in front of you to just stop. Foreplay is very, very important for both the partners, and that could lead to very breezy, easy sex. And if there's anything pathologically wrong with you that is causing you to feel that pain, like if you feel you're turned on, you really want to do it, and despite all of that you're still facing pain, then you should consult a gynec, because then there could be some pathological problem with you that could be causing the pain. I have dark underarms. What to do? Leave them. Absolutely leave them. Even I have dark underarms. I do nothing about it. Wear your sleeveless. Put on a deodorant. Don't have stinky underarms. We can't do anything about hyperpigmentation, you guys. How much will you try to cure your underarms for that matter? Leave them be. Is it okay to be a virgin at the age of 23? Abso-frickin-lutely. Absolutely. Please don't ever feel pressured by internet or by your friends or by your peers to feel like you're not, you know, cool to be a virgin at 23 or 30 or 35 or 40 or whenever you want to be a virgin. If you don't want to have sex, it's completely okay. It's up to you. It's only your point of view that matters. Don't want to do it, you don't do it. I know a lot of my friends just do it because they, you know, want to know, okay, what is the hype about? And then they do it and they're like, what was the hype about? And I was like, exactly. Why did you push yourself to do it? Just to know what the hype was about. It's nothing. I won't say it's nothing so great also. If you never get your period, you can't get pregnant. So basically, you know, in some cultures, how they celebrate when you get your first period, that is because it's a celebration that you're fertile. So when you get your period, it's like your, you know, your reproductive system is okay. It's working. It's functional. That means one day you will be able to bear child. So if you've not got your period ever, that would just mean like your reproductive system is not working properly, and hence you might have difficulties in being pregnant. Is it normal to have discoloration in intimate parts? Yes, absolutely. Hyperpigmentation, discoloration, absolutely normal. I personally have it as well. I don't do anything about it. It's completely okay. Leave it be. Like I said, certain areas of your body, they're meant to be that way. You don't, you know, jo jaisa hai usko chhedo mat. I have PCOD and the mood swings and everything related to it are just so bad. I relate to you, girl. I can't as well. Don't know what to tell you, and I'm with you on this. Is there a girl code? And if yes, what is it? I don't know if there's an actual girl code, but I know one rule. You never sleep with your best friend's ex You also don't sleep with your best friend's brother. But in my head, this is girl code. And girl code is also definitely when you're in a room and you know that eye signal that you have with your girlfriends, that is girl code for me, definitely. My left side breast is paining and it has become a little bit hard from 10 days. What can I do? What you can do is palpate. If you feel like palpate your breast and check, feel like there's a sort of a ball sort of appearance and you also feel like it's hurting you, go to a doctor immediately. You should, you must, and then the doctor will guide you. All my girls need to listen to this, all women in general, trans women, straight women, all women, that you have to palpate your breast every like say 15 days and you should check for lumps that you feel or any pain that you're feeling, or if you see any discoloration in any particular spot in your breast, then in that case you should show your gynec, because discoloration down there is okay, it's normal, but on your breast if you're having like a black blue sort of a discoloration, that could mean like internally there is something wrong, right? So you have to show your doctor. I for once did have a lump scare over here that I had once experienced and it was not painful, but it was painful, but the lump was not very well defined. But I immediately went to my doctor and he said on palpation that it was a dissolved cyst, so it was nothing to be worried about. So it's not that you always have to worry, but definitely always get yourself checked. Wearing bras every day, do we really have to? You really don't have to, but I mean, you know, you get awkward without a bra. I personally do get awkward without a bra as well, so you have to. This is just something you have to do, you know, social conduct. Would you still prefer using menstrual cups on heavy flow days? Absolutely. I'm on my third day of period, I'm using my menstrual cup today and it's super comfortable and I love everything about it. I love the fact that I don't have to run, get a newspaper, dispose my sanitary napkin or dispose my tampon somewhere, you know. It's not, I don't have to dispose anything apart from blood, which I can just dispose in my pot itself. So super convenient. Even in my sleep I can put a cup right now, I'm that confident. Belly fat and stretch marks kaise theek kare, please bataiye. Please mat theek karo, kya hai usme theek karne ke liye? Go watch this short and then come back to me. How were you dealing with period rashes? So this is something I have mentioned multiple number of times, that I get a lot of period rashes when I used to use pads. So I used to use Absorb powder. It's basically an antibacterial, antifungal powder. So I used to use that on my period when I used to wear a pad, because that's how bad my itching was and I could not, of course, itch. So I would put powder which would calm down the itching and then I would put on my pad. Drinking coffee makes menstrual cramps more worst, right? How do you get rid of this? Because I'm a coffee lover too. Now this is very personal, because for me, coffee is the cure for everything, honey. Everything. Menstrual cramps as well. It just makes my period a breeze, because I'm currently on my period and I'm hopped up on coffee. So it has a different effect on everyone. Can't tell you one straight answer. But if it doesn't work for you, then just, you know, 7 days you can. I mean, I couldn't go without coffee, but I could give you condolence ke ho jayega. Since caffeine is what must be causing your problem, decaf should help. Is it okay to masturbate at the age of 18? Absolutely, honey. You can masturbate whenever you want, whatever age. Do it if you want to. Like I've been saying about sex as well, same applies for masturbation. If you want to, if you feel the urge to, and if you feel the need to, go all out. Other than sex toys, what can we use to masturbate at home? Your hands. That was it for today's video. I know this was a very long video, but I feel like I answered so many questions and I really feel good after doing this. All of your questions were answered, I'm sure. If it's not, and if you want me to do a part two, let me know. I hope you guys enjoyed and found this helpful. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And also don't forget to share this with your other girlfriends so they find help as well for any of the questions they were looking answers for. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Tanveer Fatima. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you. Mwah.